Obeying the Gospel, June 11th, the normative nature of the Apostles' teaching. Now I would remind you, brothers, of the gospel I preached to you, which you received, in which you stand, and by which you are being saved, if you hold fast to the word I preached to you, unless you believed in vain. 1 Corinthians 15, 1 and 2. When we are adrift, we need an anchor. But when it comes to the gospel of Christ, it's extremely important what anchor we choose to employ. Changing the metaphor, we might say that our standard of measurement is important. If we need to know whether a particular belief or practice is valid, we won't get a helpful answer if we measure by the wrong yardstick. For Christians, the Scriptures are the definitive standard by which beliefs and practices are to be judged. Starting with Genesis and culminating in the writings of the Apostles of Christ, these documents are normative. That is, they define what is and what is not an authentic part of the way. On there being a way, consider Matthew 7, 13 and 14, John 14, 6, and Acts 24, 14. The Bible is, in effect, the constitution of Christianity. In the late first century, several decades after the beginning of the gospel, many began to abandon the teaching of the apostles and promote progressive views of discipleship. Against this departure, the Apostle John wrote a heartfelt plea to his brethren, urging them to ground themselves in what they had been taught by the apostles. 1 John 1, 1-4, 2, 24, and 4, 1, and 6. If they left this teaching, they would have departed from Christ. 1 John 2, 18 and 19, and 2 John 9 to 11. The crisis in John's day was the beginning of a trend that continues today. At present, it's fashionable to say that there is no norm. Christianity is whatever we wish it to be. If there is any standard, it is our own subjective feelings. As for the Bible, it is viewed as a living book whose meaning changes over time. Yet this goes against the way the apostles themselves viewed the gospel. There was, for example, no hope that the problems in Corinth would be solved if the Corinthians didn't remember what Paul had taught them as an apostle. Remember what he said? "Now I would remind you, brothers, of the gospel I preached to you, which you received, and in which you stand, and by which you are being saved, if you hold fast to the word I preached." And what if they did not hold fast? Paul left no doubt that they would have believed in vain. As John J. Chapman said, "A Christian cannot live by philosophy. Only the light of Christian revelation gives the end as well as the means of life."